Ken Trahan with Archbishop Rummel Athletic Hall of Fame inductee Charles Noble. It has a pretty good ring to it, doesn't it?
It does. It has a very good ring to it.
Well, you were part of something special. I mean, I'm a bowler, and I bowled at Rummel, and we finished second twice and could never get over the hump. Lenny Van Gilder, who worked with us, bowled here, loved Rummel, and couldn't quite get over the hump. Very good teams. You did. And talk about that and being able to win a state championship as you did, and then a second one at Rummel as well.
So it's very special to get the first one through actual just Rummel itself. But the first year I came in, we lost in the semifinals to Shaw, which is kind of heartbreaking because we had such a good team. And then coming back for my sophomore year, we brought back most of the people again, my teammates. We went undefeated also that year, and then we lost in the first round to Jesuit. It was devastating. So you're coming back to the third year, trying to do, you know, repeat the undefeated season again. We were able to. And in this time, we didn't lose in the first round. We were able to get through the second round, and we finally beat, I don't remember.
Barb, was it?
Barb, yeah. We were able to get through Barb for the championship. Yeah. And it was special because there was a couple seniors on that team that, you know, we lost to with the first 2 years, and able to get that and also bring one to Rummel. It was the first state championship in a while for all the sports, and so I just enjoyed it. And then this, my senior year coming back, we had high expectations again. We won one, we went undefeated again. So coming through, we just had to stay level-headed. It was, you know, we wanted to get very high because we were doing so well for the last 3 years. We were able to stay calm, cool, collected, and we were able to get through regular season undefeated for the fourth straight year. And then we bowled Jesuit in the semifinals, which was a match. We were able to get through them, just got by, and then we won our second state title in 2 years back-to-back, which I think that was the first time this happened in a while for Rummel. So it was just a pleasure. It was a pleasure to be part of those two teams.
Yeah, a special time. We enjoyed it thoroughly. And you mentioned Jesuit. Corey was really good. You and Corey, probably the best bowlers in the state at that particular time.
Yeah, we kept going back and forth. My junior year, Corey beat me for the best in the state by a couple pins, and it was just heartbreaking. But we ended up winning the state championship, so it was kind of worth the balance of it.
Yeah, the singles competition is separate, of course.
Correct.
So looking back on it, you know, you had a chance to go to Alabama, Bowling College, Bodenheimer,
yes.
Did the same, and I'm sure this prepared you well, and I'm sure you had a great experience.
I had a great experience. Spring Hill was awesome to me. It was awesome to be able to start the program there and then see it flourish as it is now. I enjoyed every second of it.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting because Matt Kerr was the moderator. I know Brian Bodenheimer helped coach at the time, but
yeah.
Matt's now running the school, so pretty special to come back and find him in that position, right?
It was. It was when I saw he got promoted to running the school, it was awesome because of the time and dedication he spent with us, nurturing, you know, a passion for our game, and then also making sure we were great young men at the same time. It was awesome to see.
And you're still bowling, I know that.
I am still bowling, yes sir.
And averaging what?
I average currently 236.
Enough said. Rummel Hall of Famer Charles Noble, 232. Congratulations, Charles.
Thank you, sir. Y'all have a great day.